If you go into a jewelry store looking to make a purchase, the salesperson might ask you some really interesting questions. Are you going to wear this every day? Do you want a ring or a pendant? How hard are you on your jewelry? Do you take your rings off when you get home, or do you sleep in them? It's not an interrogation. The salesperson's just trying to find what gemstone is going to be suitable for your lifestyle. They're going to make some judgment calls for what kind of stones they think you would be able to wear every day. In gemology, there are two metrics that we usually use to measure the durability of a stone: hardness and toughness. They are not the same thing. Basically, we use these terms to determine whether or not a customer should be able to wear their piece every day, and jewelers use this information when setting. It's also a big factor in whether or not certain gemstones are more likely to go in rings that are gonna come in contact with lots of things, or in like pendants or earrings that are not gonna have as much contact with everyday objects. For instance, tanzanite has a hardness of 6 to 7 out of 10, which is good, and we'll explain that in a minute. But any jeweler will tell you that tanzanite is very hard to set because it breaks easily. That's because regardless of its good hardness, it has poor toughness. So while a 6 to 7 hardness on paper sounds pretty good, it's still a stone that can be easily broken. Don't get me wrong, you should still buy tanzanite. It's just something that you want to wear with care, especially if it's in a ring. So hardness and toughness are two different things, like I said. Hardness refers to resistance to scratching. Toughness refers to resistance to breaking. Let's start with hardness. In gemology, we're usually determining hardness based on the Mohs scale of mineral hardness. The Mohs method of determining hardness or resistance to scratching is based upon which minerals can scratch which other minerals. So for instance, sapphire can scratch topaz. So sapphire is ranked higher on the Mohs scale. The Mohs scale starts at 1, represented by talc, meaning that everything else on the scale can scratch any mineral that is ranked 1 in hardness. The hardest mineral, or most resistant to scratching, is diamond. So diamond is actually a 10 on the Mohs scale of mineral hardness. So it's a 1 to 10 scale, diamond being a 10, meaning diamond can scratch all other minerals. Diamonds can also scratch each other. So you don't ever want to put diamonds in a bag or jewelry box together if it's going to be shaken around, because the diamonds could come in contact with each other and scratch. The hardness thing gets kind of complicated, but stick with me. There is an objective value called absolute hardness assigned to each gemstone, which better demonstrates the discrepancy in hardness between two minerals. Sapphire is a 9 on the hardness scale, and diamond is a 10 on the hardness scale. They sound pretty close, right? Wrong. Diamond can scratch sapphire, and sapphire can scratch every gem that's a 9 or below. This makes sapphire and diamond sound very, very close in hardness, but if you actually examine their absolute hardness value, sapphire has an absolute hardness of 400, whereas diamond has an absolute hardness of 1500. This means that the distance between sapphire and diamond on the hardness scale is greater than the distance between 1 and 9, or talc in sapphire, on the hardness scale. So the difference between 9 and 10, greater than the difference between 1 and 9. So a jadeite jade, which is usually gonna be about 6.5 to 7 on the Mohs scale, is actually closer in hardness or resistance to scratching than sapphire is to diamond. If you're determining your gemstone purchase based on hardness, consult your local jeweler. They've been around the block, and they'll be able to give you advice based on your lifestyle, how often and how you wear your jewelry, how it will be mounted and in what type of jewelry, and how you plan on wearing the gem. Now to toughness. Toughness is resistance to breaking. Toughness is a whole other thing, and like hardness, there's multiple ways to measure it. But in gemology, we base it on the fracture toughness scale. The fracture toughness scale measures the work required to separate two surfaces of a crystal along a certain crystallographic plane. This value is measured in ERGs, which is a unit of energy. Because these numbers and values get complicated, toughness doesn't have a 1 to 10 scale like hardness does. In gemology, we use these terms to generalize toughness: poor, fair, good, and excellent. And in the case of jadeite jade and nephrite jade, we use the term exceptional. This is because jade is two of the toughest gemstones on the entire planet Earth, second and third only to hematite, which is arguably a metal. If you're determining your gemstone purchase based on toughness, again, consult your local jeweler. They'll have a much better frame of reference for the type of gemstone that you're looking at. The toughness value of sapphire measures 600 ERGs per centimeter. The toughness of diamond measures between 5,000 and 8,000, which is considered good. I didn't mean the quotes, it really is good. If diamond wasn't suitable for everyday wear, if it wasn't tough enough to withstand it, it wouldn't be the number one choice for engagement rings in the United States. The toughness value of jadeite is 120,000, and the toughness value of nephrite jade is around 225,000 ERGs per centimeter. So diamond's toughness is rated good, and nephrite jade's toughness is still 28 to 45 times the toughness of diamond. Clear as mud? Keep an eye out for more gemology videos where we'll talk about this more. Do you consider hardness and toughness before making a jewelry purchase? Let us know in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe and follow me on Instagram.